True to its brethren, this coffee cousin promises to put a different kind of pep in your step. While its leaves have been used for centuries medicinally to give chewers a boost, controversy swirls about the effectiveness and the risks of this wonder plant. This is Kratom. Hey, I'm Tasha and you're watching Florologic. Today, I'm totally amped to tell you about Mitragyna speciosa, otherwise known as Kratom. This plant has been considered a helper of humanity for hundreds of years in its home region, but even helpers have their dark sides. Kratom is a tropical evergreen tree native to Southeast Asia. It grows in the wild at low elevations in swampy forests, but it's also widely cultivated for medicinal and recreational use. Kratom is a member of the Rubiaceae family, sometimes also called the Madder family. Even if you've never heard of this 14,000 species strong family, you've probably tasted the roasted beans of Rubiaceae's most famous member, coffee. Unlike the shrubby coffee plant, Kratom can grow up to 15 meters or 50 feet tall. The flowers of the Kratom tree are arranged into dense spherical clusters and look like little fireworks. On the outside, the leaves of the Kratom appear pretty standard: green, glossy, lots of veins. But go inside and you'll discover that these leaves pack a punch. Similar to coffee, users of Kratom take low doses as an upper to boost alertness and energy. And much like coffee, it will also increase the heart rate as a result. In rural areas of Southeast Asia, Kratom is chewed by laborers to ward off fatigue and alleviate pain. While little doses of Kratom lift users up, higher doses do just the opposite. Larger amounts of Kratom act as a sedative, with users sharing that it calms them down and reduces their pain and anxiety. Like any drug, Kratom is not without side effects. The milder ones include dry mouth, nausea and vomiting, high blood pressure, dizziness, and muscle pain. The most common are agitation, racing heart rate, drowsiness, and confusion. More serious side effects include liver damage, breathing problems, tremors, and seizures, as well as psychological effects like hallucinations, delusions, and depression. Long-term use of high doses of Kratom can cause weight loss, muscle spasms, as well as muscle and joint pain, and aggression, to name a few. Kratom can be taken a number of ways. The most straightforward is to chew directly on the leaves, similar to how coca leaves are traditionally chewed. If you're curious to learn more about the coca leaf, you can watch the whole video here. Kratom can also be brewed into tea, turned into extracts, dried and ground up, and turned into capsules or tablets. It can even be smoked. Once taken, Kratom starts working within minutes and can last up to a few hours. The more Kratom that's taken, the stronger the effect. So what is it about Kratom that peps us humans up or calms us down? Like most of the 14,000 members of the coffee family, Kratom contains alkaloids. These are chemical compounds naturally found in plants. Alkaloids are there mostly to deter herbivores, insects, and pathogens. But alkaloids can have wacky effects on humans too. So far, we know of about 20,000 alkaloids. The caffeine of coffee, for example, is considered one of the more benign alkaloids that humans use. Others, like highly addictive nicotine, morphine, and cocaine, are not so harmless. There are a ton of alkaloids in Kratom, but the most studied are metragenine and 7-hydroxymetragenine. These produce opioid-like effects. The difference with Kratom alkaloids is that they don't initiate the pathways in the brain that affect breathing like opiates do. An overdose of morphine or heroin can make the user stop breathing entirely, leading to their death. Initial studies have shown that Kratom may not cause this so-called respiratory depression like opiates do. Research is also starting to show that Kratom isn't as addictive as morphine or heroin, but so far, scientists don't understand why not. In the midst of a global opioid crisis, with 60 million people struggling with addiction and 100,000 people dying every year, finding solutions to this massive problem couldn't be more urgent. In addition to treating pain and boosting energy, Kratom in Southeast Asia has been used to combat opiate withdrawal symptoms for centuries. Now it seems that scientists are catching up with this traditional knowledge. Initial findings have suggested that Kratom, and metragenine specifically, may even be more effective than methadone in fighting opiate withdrawal symptoms. Because of its opioid-like effect, without some of the unwanted side effects, Kratom is also being investigated as a non-opioid pain reliever. This could mean heading off a huge number of opioid addictions before they even start. But much more study needs to be done to completely understand the benefits. Even the risks of Kratom aren't yet fully understood. What we do know is that too much Kratom can cause psychotic symptoms and possibly also psychological and physiological dependence. Overdose of Kratom is rare, but not impossible. There are a small number of reports of deaths associated with Kratom, but it's difficult to tell what role the plant actually played, since most of these deaths also involved other harmful substances. Despite centuries of medicinal use in Southeast Asia, kratom has only recently become more popular in the West, with as many as 5 million estimated regular users in the US. Authorities claim that most of these users take kratom recreationally, but a study that used the YouTube data tool analyzed videos uploaded about kratom and found that self-medicating against opioid addiction, pain, anxiety, depression, and substance use were the major reasons people reported using kratom. Kratom is often marketed as a natural supplement in the West, with different strains called red, green, and white, based on the color of the leaf veins, along with the region of origin. One study aimed to find the difference between these strains and found that most respondents gave answers that aligned with the marketing jargon of each strain. But chemical analysis showed there was little difference between the three. In kratom's native Southeast Asia, there are no strains marketed to users. The United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime hasn't declared kratom a controlled drug under international conventions, but it's urged member states to monitor trends of its use and decide their own classifications. In the Netherlands, for example, it's legal, but in the US, it's only partially legal. Due to its potential for addiction, kratom is illegal in Singapore and Malaysia. Kratom was also made illegal in Thailand back in 1943, but lawmakers have been trying to decriminalize it for a few decades now. Because of this, it's often sold by the same people who sell other illegal substances, making it harder to control and impossible to ensure its safety. The issue with kratom is that it's completely unregulated when sold as a health food product. The levels of alkaloids or even what's contained in these kratom products can vary widely, which can lead to unwanted overdose. The silver lining of being unregulated is that researchers can conduct studies on kratom without restriction too. That means that all of the potential and all of the risks that might come along with kratom can be fully explored. So what should we talk about next? Drop me your comments below and don't forget to subscribe for new videos every week. And if you like this episode, check out our similar episodes on kat, a similar plant from the Arabian Peninsula. Bye-bye.
Hey everyone, we have exciting news. We're thrilled to announce the release of Animalogic's very first book, Strange Creatures. This book dives into the most incredible animals we've ever featured on the show, with each chapter packed with my illustrations and stunning full-color images. It's a fun and engaging way to learn about the animal kingdom, and a perfect tool to spark kids' interest in science. Each chapter breaks down an animal's biology, behavior, and all the coolest facts you need to know about these fascinating creatures. Animalogic's Strange Creatures is a must-have addition to your own library, or the perfect gift for an animal lover this upcoming holiday season. Click the link in the description to check it out, and if you can, pre-order a copy. Pre-ordering would help us get an extra bump in the Amazon algorithm, and that would mean the world to us. So thank you so much.